What's up, everybody? I'm sure most of you at this point have seen this brand new 100 Gifts event. It came out like 12 hours ago. They announced it. 7th anniversary, 100 Gifts. There's a lot of good stuff in here. However, I have this feeling, I have this just gut feeling that they were actually forced to do this event. This was not something that they intentionally wanted to give out such good gifts, just out of the kindness of their heart. They already gave a lot of 7th anniversary events. I'm sure they had some event slated for this time, like this week, right? Or actually, this is going to be a month-long event, a little bit over a month. So I'm sure they had another event planned for this, or maybe this specific event, but I don't know if they planned on doing it this good, and we'll get to that in a second, but let's take a brief recap of all the... Because there's a lot of stuff in this event. Okay, so 7th anniversary special, June 6th. I mean, I'm sure a lot of you guys have already seen this as well. I was going to do a video on this earlier today because, like I said, it came out 12 hours ago. But I saw there were already a handful of other channels that did videos on it. I'm like, okay, well, I had a video already prepared for this morning anyway. So that's fine. Let them have some views. So how to get play points. You just do all the content. It's nothing special. How to get bonus points, power up runes, craft runes, skill up monsters, evolve monsters, summon default monsters, right? You could just get it day one if you just whale and summon all the Even if I had the scrolls on my accounts, actually I do have the scrolls on my accounts. I got like 100 scrolls on free win. I don't even want to summon them. I was so summoned out. I'm tired of getting 3 stars. I'm just so summoned out. But anyway, it's a month-long event, and you go. They're gonna have little things where you take a trip down memory lane with Summoner's War, and you see different things from all the updates in the game. It's a hey guys, look at the history we have together. Please don't leave. Please don't leave. Please don't play other games. Please don't leave. It's kind of one of those, right? So we get Rainbow Mon, Angel Mon, XP Booster, Mana Stones, Energy. That's basically nothing. I mean, energy at this point, they have to give energy in events. Otherwise, there's no way for some people to realistically play. Like, they have to give a lot of energy out. They used to not. I mean, they used to still give out energy, but not quite this much. Angel Mon, Ancient Coins, Mystical Scrolls. Mana is nothing. Devilmon is nice. More energy, more 3-star rainbow. 3-star rainbow mons, like, all you have to do is do like a 10 run of R5, and then you get 2 rainbow mons. Or any Rift Beast, really. Fire Scroll, Water Scroll, Wind Scroll. So really, it's... Let's be real. There's some filler stuff. There's energy, there's mana stones, there's 3-star rainbow mons. There's some filler stuff. I would say maybe there's like 50 to 70 like actual rewards. But still, that's a lot of rewards. For what this is, again, 3-star Rainbow Mon, Energy, Mana Stones. You get a Legendary, you get some Mysticals, you get another Angel Mon, some Glory Points are okay, Summoning Stone times 50, but I mean, it's just one summon. It's just get the 3-star that you want. More 3-star Rainbow Mon. So, like, again, this is Mana Stones and Rainbow Mons are just filler. Mystical Scrolls. We're kind of approaching the level of the game 7 years later where Mystical Scrolls are almost filler at this point. They're like, well, we get 3 stars, so that's cool. LD Scroll, so LD 3-star. 4-star Raymond, Symbol of Harmony. You can't really even craft anything with these, though. That's the thing, is just crafting 5-star runes, so it's poo-poo runes. But at least you get more points for the event by crafting the runes that you get with these symbols, because basically you really don't get too much out of that. I mean, we've done videos crafting like 5,000, 10,000 points worth of this stuff, and we get like a couple runes. So it's really almost nothing. I mean, you could almost argue that these are a kind of filler too at this point, because there's no way to craft 6-star only runes. Rune piece. Oh, right. This one's filler as well. These rune pieces times 100, because you need those for these as well. Immortal Grindstone. That's pretty good. Immortal Gem. That's pretty good, right? Then we have Energy, Legend Rune. So the Legend Rune is okay, but it's random, right? At this point, many of us is like, yeah, the only time I care if it's like Violent or Will or Rage or like one of the like six usable runes, right? Because a lot of times we're not using Energy, we're not using Guard, we're not using Endure, we're not using things like that. We can only use like a few different rune sets for the units nowadays. I mean, again, 7 years later, it's all about PvP. Because that's what was intended. That's what was intended by the devs. But anyway, we get some more scrolls here. You guys get the idea. More scrolls, more filler, some edits, more filler here. These are all fillers. Crystals are nice. Mana stones, more filler. So maybe you know what? I'm kind of seeing since these symbols are, maybe we get like 50 to 60 actual rewards. And then the like 40 are filler. But anyway, we got a lot of juicy stuff. The point is, we got a lot of juicy stuff. We got another Devilmon. So there's two Devilmons altogether. There's quite a large handful of scrolls and some other stuff from here. So there's a lot of stuff that you get from this event. I'm sure everyone's very excited. Oh, and a Fairy Queen Transmog, which is actually, between that and the Devilmons, those are the things that I'm most excited about. Because I use Frayn all the time on all the accounts. So I'm very excited about that. But the question is, would you rather have all of this stuff, or would you rather have this? Now, many of you don't know what exactly this is that I'm showing you guys. This is Epic 7, and the point of this is not to get you to play Epic 7 or anything. The point of this is just to show you, play Devil's Advocate, and show you guys what Epic 7 is doing right now, because a lot of times, Epic 7 is one of the biggest competitors to Summoner's War. That's why I'm showing this, right? So, a lot of times, the devs from Epic 7 put a lot of pressure on Comptuas and Summoner's War because Epic 7 will release something crazy and interesting and new and exciting, and then Comptuas will be like, crap, we have to play catch-up now. And then this is a lot of times why we get nice stuff, is that they feel like, okay, the competitor is doing it. We need to give our players something extra, something more, so that they don't feel like they're missing out by not playing something else and playing Summoner's War instead. So this is something that Epic 7 just did, is that they are giving out LD units, LD5 units. So they're not some of the newer LD5s, they're some of the kind of older LD5s. But could you imagine, and you just, like, they're just giving them out. You can't have all of them, but you get to decide which one you want on your account, and there you go. It's congratulations, you've got an LD5 in Epic 7. They also have pity timers for LD5s from the Mystic Metals, which is kind of like Summoning Stones in Summoner's War, to give you guys like a comparison. So it is actually like, if you summon enough in Epic 7, you still do get like ML5 is LD5, right? It's the same thing basically, like light and dark, right? So the point is that this came out in Epic 7, and now, is this what's pushing Comptuas to give us some really nice juicy rewards in Summoner's War? Again, these are not like the new LD5 kind of things. These are not new ML5s. These are kind of like some of the older ML5s. But could you imagine if in the Summoner's War version of this, there was an event that said, hey, thanks for sticking with us for 7 years. You can choose one of 7 LD5s. You can choose Artemiel, you can choose Ragdoll, you can choose Asima, you can choose a Chroma. Could you imagine how that would even be perceived? People's minds would be blown. But Comptuas is like, there's no way we're going to give out an LD5. There's no way we're going to do that. No way. We're not going to do that. So let's give them a bunch of stuff and filler and 100 years worth of rewards. Sometimes it feels like I've been farming for 100 years. 100 rewards, 7 years worth of gameplay, whatever. Because they're like, we're not giving out LD5s. We're not going to give all our players these. But I feel like this could be... No, maybe I'm wrong, right? Just playing devil's advocate. But I feel like this could be one of the things that's inspired Comptuas to be very generous lately with some of these 7-year events. I mean, that, and then there's... Genshin isn't really giving out anything special crazy. It's more like the Epic 7 likes to give out things special crazy and then also put out updates. A lot of times Comptuas will look at the Epic 7 updates and be like, crap, we have to... Also, some of the Summoner's War devs moved to Epic 7. You guys didn't know. That happened a while ago, but yeah, that happened. But a lot of times Comptuas will look at the stuff in Epic 7 and be like, crap, now we gotta put things... in the game, because Epic 7 did this this update, and people are excited about that. People like it. Okay, maybe we'll stick this in the game. It used to be the other way around. It used to be Summoner's War was leading the pack, and everyone else was following. And now, I feel like Summoner's War is just like Epic 7 like doing this, and the Comptuas was like, okay, let's do that too. That looked like it went well. Let's do that too. So, anyway, would you rather have the 100 events or the 100? The 100 events. Would you rather have the 100 rewards or 100 gifts from this event, or would you rather have a choose your own LD5 from Summoner's War? I'm not saying the Epic 7. I'm just saying, would you rather have, like, if you could choose between the 100 gifts event or like one of 7 choices, like again, like Ragdoll, Akroma, Artemiel, I don't remember what I even said before, but like one of seven LD5s. I feel like a lot of people would just be like, LD5, I've been waiting years for this. It's finally time, right? Anyway, just food for thought. Anyway, that's it for this one. Hope you guys enjoyed it, got a kick out of it. I'm just stirring the pot now, is all I'm doing, but I'm curious. I feel like this is, again, this has happened in the past, is Epic 7 and other games put pressure on CompTOS to actually give us good stuff. And this is why competition in the marketplace is good in economics, right? If you only have one choice, and you only have Summoner's War, only have Epic 7, then they could just do whatever they want. They could screw you all they want. And what are you going to do? You don't have a choice, right? But if there's all these different mobile games that are getting attention, especially anytime new mobile games come out, CompTOS is like, no, don't go play that. We're going to give you this cool of event and reward and keep farming and keep farming. We don't want you to even close the app to start playing another game. That's really the thing. They don't want you to even close Summoner's War to play another game. They want you to be in the app all day, every day. That's the point. They want you in there and not exploring other territories. So, anyway, that's it for this one. Like I said, just stirring the pot like I always do. What would you choose? Anyway, that's it for this one. I'll see you as always in the next one.